from New York, or as live as this show gets, it's Prime Time with George Durunda. Tonight, the Polish princess Carolyn Lee, and the lovely and talented Jeannie sings with Reflection, plus the fabulous Radiators. So get ready for the most entertaining show on television!
Hi, I'm George Durunda, and welcome to Primetime. And let me tell you, what a show we have for you tonight. Yes, we're here downtown New York City. Start spreading the news. Yes, we're here at Madison Square Garden. And I believe all next week, they're scheduled to have the annual Guys Who Slept with Madonna convention. I believe it'll be a six-day event. Hey, it's an all-new episode of Primetime. Yes, and here to start off the big show from New York, it's the lovely and talented Jeannie with Reflection performing Good For Me.
Sing with the band.
she keeps kicking sand at me. Yes, that was the lovely and talented Jeannie performing with Reflection. And you know, we're here down in New York. Mr. Doug, however, conspicuous by his absence, didn't want to come with us to New York City. He decided to stay back in Chicopee, but we left the camera back there with him. Let's see what he's doing back in Chicopee.
If you like piña coladas and getting caught in the rain.
He's not in Chicopee at all. He's dancing at Quabbin. At least he's changed the song. I mean, it used to be zip, zip, zippity, doo da. And it's going to take me about 6 months to get that song out of my head. Hey, we'll return with more fun here in New York and royalty.
If you like piña coladas.
Boy, I really did it last night. Got drunk, acted stupid, went home with... Who is that? What, am I stupid? How did I do this? Barry began to worry, really worry. What about AIDS? Then he remembered, hey, I'm just a cartoon. I don't even have to shower. Get high, get stupid, get AIDS.
The fire will ring Hulk Hogan today. This is the truth. You know how long the match would last? About 3 or 4 minutes. I could kill
you. You might have a few gas pockets after you eat your pizza. Who knows?
Prime time! You're the greatest! I love these guys!
I love the taste of chicken meat. I live for the taste of chicken meat.
We want color.
Are you serious?
Well, us television star personality types.
Ooh, connections.
I say nothing.
I said, if we don't have what you want, we'll order it. Yes, welcome back to the big program here in New York City. We're here at Carnegie Hall, and my next guest has performed here, and she is now in the official Carnegie Hall archives. It's a pleasure to bring back to the program once again at home with the one and only Polish princess, Carolyn Lee. Carolyn! Carolyn!
Well, Carolyn, welcome back to the program, but I don't know if we're as welcome in your house.
Well,
we were just in the area. We thought we'd stop by.
Oh, well, and as always, you know, you're always welcome here, but you'll have to excuse me because, as you can see, I'm dressed in shorts and I'm on my way to a cookout.
A cookout? I thought you were out for the evening.
No,
you're grilling up some burgers. Like the grilling up Golden Burgers outfit.
I want to make a statement, you know?
You know, I wonder if the place of the Golden Arches should...
I'd probably blend right in with them, huh? So it's nice to see you again, George, and, you know, it's always nice to have you here.
Well, we have to keep checking up on these princess updates.
Well, there's always something new and exciting happening, you know.
I understand the latest new and exciting, it was Liberace's ring, or Liberace. Now, I understand some people called him Liberace.
Yeah, they probably didn't like him. It's like chopping, you know, when people say, well, I'll go and play chopping.
Yeah, play some of that.
Yeah, chopping, you know, you can see the hotness in it.
It's a Chinese, you know,
Liberace,
music,
yeah. Actually, yeah, right. Actually,
rice, plenty of rice.
This is really a very, very, as you can see, it's a little unique. And I received this as a total surprise. As a matter of fact, I have the letter here, and I'd like to read it. It only takes a minute or so.
No. Let's look at that ring again. Look at it.
55 carats.
55 carats.
Pure something with 6 emeralds on each side.
Emeralds. 6 emeralds.
Yeah, on each side. And I decided.
The emeralds are green. And
it's a Liberace ring. And I decided to wear it in between the grand piano and the candelabra at my performances. I feel it's just, I always feel like he'll be with me now. And this was a total surprise. I received a package from Dora Liberace, who is his sister-in-law, George the violinist, his wife. And it said, I'll read it to you because it really is a moving letter. It came in April 2nd. It says, Dear Carolyn, the ring enclosed was a gift from Lee Liberace. He bought it for me when we went to a jewelry convention here in Las Vegas. He said, Dora, you have to have this ring. It is a copy of the ring worn by Joan Collins on the TV program Dynasty. I feel it brings back so many memories. You would think after all these years the hurt would be fading, but it still lingers. I can't think of anyone more suitable to wear this ring than you, Carolyn. Please wear it in good health. and may you have a full house and a standing ovation every time you wear it. With affection, Dora Liberace. And needless to say, this was... I'm speechless.
You're speechless. And that's unusual to yet have the princess become speechless.
And every time I read this letter, you know, it brings back such pleasant memories I've had with Lee. And, you know, I do a tribute to him all over the country.
Internationally now.
Internationally now. That's right. I'd say it all over the country. But that's right. I'm now an international star.
You're just like me, an international multimedia megastar.
Well, I don't know about the multimedia, you know, media, but I mean, you know, it's really nice to have that. Yeah. International. But now I really feel that.
Now, how are you going to get this ring in and out of Poland?
Oh, my. I don't know. I had it when I went to Poland this year, and I didn't take it. I had never been to Poland. I didn't know how the security was and everything like that, you know. But
would you feel comfortable taking this to Poland?
No. No. I didn't even take my candelabra or grand piano ring. I didn't know what to expect this year, but maybe next year. I don't know. I'm getting to be an old pro with this Poland thing, you know. By the way, anyone wants to join us in Poland next year in May?
You're running another trip?
Yeah. 13 days of...
13 sunshine, fun-filled days with Carolyn Lee, the Polish princess. You've never been to Poland until you've been there with the Polish princess.
That's true. And, you know, we have an itinerary, but there's so many more surprises that are just... couldn't possibly be put in this itinerary.
Look, waking up in the next room for you could be a surprise.
Well, this is true. And, you know, I had a lady this year, and this is a very good, you know, I thought this was excellent. She had been 8 times to Poland, and this was her 8th time with me. Mm-hmm. And she said in all the 7 times before, she never saw and had as much fun all together as she did this one trip with me. So that was quite a...
I can't imagine why. Now, the food, I understand, though, isn't too good because you had a... cook your own food and...
Well, no, we had a picnic. No, that was really cute. They served us bigos, which is like a cabbage type thing, and we cooked kibasa on a campfire.
And Missy dropped yours in the dirt?
Missy dropped mine in the dirt, like 3 pieces, and she said, hey, God made dirt, eat it. You know, I mean...
Oh!
Boston, future mother-in-law. Yeah,
protein.
You know. But we just had so much fun. Of course, you know, you have to get the knack of it. Mine started on fire. Why do you believe this? I was the only one with, you know, fire all over my stick, and we thought we need a fire extinguisher. But we had so much fun. We went up
into
the
mountains. You had chicken dinners also at the hotel. You had a cookout on the patio.
Yeah, we had cookouts on the patio. We had Polish entertainment galore. We had, you know, it was just like, I can't begin
to tell you. Now, what is the entertainment like in Poland?
Totally like the when we were around Krakow. Mm-hmm. We had the Krakowiak entertainment. When we went into Zakopane, we had the Gorale, which is like a totally different entertainment. When we went into the Kasubi region, we had the Kasubian. All totally different entertainment. And of course, next year, they're going to have the Carolyn Lee, the Polish Princess Polka Party at the Hotel Forum in Krakow.
The entire band.
We're hoping to take the entire band. We're hoping, yes. But we will take some of them.
But the entertainment is patterned regionally, so it's kind of like if you go to Nashville, you hear country and western.
Exactly, exactly. And I was totally amazed because I figured I'd get some real nice Polish cassettes. Forget it. Heavy metal. I mean, you know, where can I get a Polish cassette in this country, you know? It's like, so I just have to come home and cut my own. That's all. And that's coming up in March. I'm going to have my first totally Polish cassette.
A first? You've never had a totally Polish cassette before?
No, I have some Polish.
Now how many cassettes have you released up to this point?
3. And we'll have 2 new ones released next spring. Totally Polish one, and then an update of the Carolyn Lee show. Which is always a surprise.
Unbelievable. And, of course, I'm sure you'll have some more videos coming out in the future.
Yes.
You have your video of Poland.
Yes, that has just been released. And hopefully now I would like to have a video of the Carolyn Lee Show. We have many, many requests for it. But the problem is I'm just so involved in so many things that all this takes time and... You know,
well, just planning a trip to Poland, it must take you hours and hours and hours.
It's a lot of work. And then planning the show. And you have to remember, I do all the arranging for the orchestra. I do, you know, I produce the whole show, produce it and direct it. And it's very time-consuming.
Doing everything from choreography to lighting to...
Right. To my rhinestone guitar. You haven't...
I haven't seen your rhinestone guitar.
You haven't lifted. You see me do achy breaky hot on my unique rhinestone guitar. It's a one-of-a-kind item. I'm sure you believe that. And I did it at Carnegie Hall the last time I was there, and the corporate officers gave me a standing ovation. I thought that was pretty cool, because, you know, to do Achy Breaky Heart at Carnegie Hall on a rhinestone guitar, you would never have done this 20 years ago.
I think it's a first.
And I also
it may be an only.
Yeah. No, they really liked it. And I also do Patsy Cline's Crazy. So I've got a little country now into the show, too. And by the way, your area is very well represented at my shows. So keep those buses coming, folks. Thanks.
What's the number again? It's 1-800-242-SHOW.
There you go. That's right. And that's how you can get on our mailing list. We can send you an update, a newsletter of what's happening, because there's always something happening.
There is there?
Yeah. Did I tell you about the dead bird on my balcony in Poland?
Was that dinner?
No, it wasn't dinner. We could enter, oh, I don't know where we were. If it's Tuesday, it had to be Poznań. I don't know. But we could enter Poznań and had this beautiful view overlooking. Of course, being the hostess from America, I had, you know, we always had excellent accommodations. And I said, oh, I got to take this view. The sun was setting and everything else. And I go out on a balcony and I got the river shot. And it was just gorgeous. And all of a sudden, I'm scanning the balcony. Oh, my, a dead pigeon on my balcony, of which about 13 other pigeons are feeding. Well, I almost died, right? So, oh, my. Now, this is what's nice about buying my video from Poland, because you get my sense of humor on this video, you know? And you hear all these
dead birds,
things.
No extra charge. You show me another Poland video and I can show you dead pigeons on a balcony.
That's so true, you know? So, and I had this hearty laugh, of course. And as I'm doing this documentary on Poland, very, very serious. Here we are in Poznań, and this is a view from our room. And oh my God, we got a dead pigeon, you know? This Poland documentary, and I'm not thinking that this is a video that will be resold to the public, you know. So right in the middle of this beautiful documentary, and oh my, I got a dead pigeon.
You almost fell off a balcony too.
We were in Gdynia, and we had this beautiful. This is like Florida, you know, and the seaport is right there, and of course our rooms, and there's casinos there. Oh heck, I almost bought half of those rooms. That's another story, but. And, you know, all of a sudden you see this beautiful seaport and I'm really getting carried away. And there was this nice shot of this boat. And I figured if I leaned a little bit more, I could get a better shot. And,
You almost got a better shot.
I ever thought of committing suicide. That was a perfect time because it was happening.
Do they have beaches in Poland?
Yes, real nice one. Sopot, Poland is really, it was really nice. We're going there this year. We're going to spend more time there, you know. So it was unique.
It always is.
It was unique, you know. So, I mean, that's pretty much an update of what's been happening. Of course, my performances, I'm all over next year. But see, if they want another performance schedule, 1-800-242-SHOW.
Are you going back to Carnegie Hall?
I was supposed to go this year, and they were a little bit upset, but my youngest son is getting married. And I was just too tight on schedules.
Some things are more important.
Yeah, yes, I do have a family and six grandkids. So next year, hopefully, we're trying to put it in the schedule now. So, because I am booked until 1995.
Yeah, they're booking jobs. 2 years.
Yeah. Because, you know, I can give them a very varied program, whether they want an all Polish show, whether they want, you know, my shows are very varied.
So your show is a 2-hour show, but you can change it, alter it.
I can adapt to anything.
You can adapt to any situation.
I can. If you get a crane in, I'll fly on stage for you if you want. I mean,
wow!
Yeah, I haven't tried that yet. That would be
unique. Let's go to Disney World.
Okay. Well, Peter Pan.
Well, Carolyn, do you think you could play us off? I think we're about out of time.
Oh, sure. We'll sign you off
a little bit. We'll play us into the break. Hey, stick around, folks.
Okay.
We'll be back.
We're going to play more
primetime fun right after this. Are we ready, Carolyn?
Well, just about. Yeah, my wire's caught. I almost strangled myself.
You know how painful that can be. Here we go. See you. Adios.
Dobra noc, kochanie.
Thank you. During the Gulf War, alongside our full-time troops stood another important group of people, the men and women of the National Guard and Reserve. In fact, they make up over 44% of our nation's defense. It makes you wonder where we would be without them. When your employees need time off to serve, be a hero. Give them the freedom to protect ours.
We're out to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
He's occasionally giving us day-old ribs. When he was going to throw them out, he let us have them.
I'm always kind, aren't I?
Well. Richard Kendra is my aim, and public health is my game.
Chet Dragon, you have a wonderful, wonderful costume tonight.
I say nothing.
We're licensed and rodent-free. Yes, we're here in New York City. We're at Dave Letterman's Theater. You know, it was only 20 shows ago right here in primetime that we were at his house. Now we found him at the theater. Guess what? He's not here either. He's never home. I'll tell you, the princess. I don't think you'll be seeing the Polish princess on David Letterman's show. No, that's exclusively for primetime. Let's check back in Chicopee and see what Doug's doing. Is he still dancing?
If you like pina coladas.
Yeah, he's still up at Quabbin dancing. I'm telling you, it's a much more catchy tune than the one he was dancing to, you know, on previous shows. But here's another group that Dave will never have on his show, at least not in the foreseeable future. It's the Fabulous Radiators performing Barefootin'.
You make me nervous when you're in your seat. Take off your shoes and tap your feet. Do not dance, it can't be beat. We're barefootin', 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 yeah, barefootin'. Hey, little girl with the red dress on, bet you could barefoot all night long. Take off your shoes and throw them away. Can get on another day. Barefootin', yeah, barefootin', barefootin', yeah, barefootin'. Just the other night, long told Sally she was out of sight. Threw off a wig and a high sneakers too. Doing a dance without any shoes. She's barefootin', yeah, barefootin', barefootin', yeah, barefootin'. John Henry said to Sue, if I'm barefoot, would you barefoot too? Sue St. John studied too.
Yes, the fabulous Radiators, and we're here at Rockefeller Center, NBC Studios, Dave's old stomping grounds. I'll bet they really miss him around here. Let's check back. Is Doug still dancing over there at Quabbin?
If you like pina coladas and getting caught in the rain.
If you like pina coladas, a catchy tune. I'll tell you, I think this far surpasses his previous endeavors here on the program. And hey, I guess we're all out of videotape in New York City, or we're out of batteries, one or the other. Good night, everyone.
If you like pina coladas and getting caught in the rain. If you're not into yoga, if you have half a brain. If you like making love at midnight in the dunes on the Cape. Then I'm the love that you've looked for. Write to me and escape. About my lady, I know that sounds kind of mean, but me and my old lady have fallen into the same old routine. So I wrote to the paper, took out a personal ad, and though I'm nobody's poet, I thought it wasn't half bad. Yes, I like pina colada.
All living things in the forest. But he can't do it alone. Please don't play with matches. Put out your campfires. And never, ever forget the words of Smokey Bear.
Only you can prevent forest fires.
If you think dealing with me is unique, you ain't seen nothing.
This looks like my kind of circus, I'll tell you that.
What do you do when you're interviewing an elephant and the elephant has nothing to say?
Well, if they feel like they can take me on, let's go to it.
You know, Dave has a lot of squirrels running around in his yard. And by the way, Doug, this could be Jurassic Park, but it certainly isn't Jurassic Park. More entertainment than you deserve.
Each year, 500,000 people have strokes, but it doesn't have to mean the end of their lives or their lifestyles. Find out the warning signs of stroke from your American Heart Association. It could help you get back into the swing of things.
If you-